reigning world champions. Zana Grytchukin of Guinea Platov setting their stall out early on, and it was obviously going to be very difficult to beat.
Well, they really did set the standard, and mighty high it was too. Such a difficult dance. The Golden Waltz, in fact, was Klimova and Ponomarenko's original dance back in 1987. They put that together with Dubova, and the ISU deciding to make it a compulsory dance for this year. Just so many turns and so many changes of hold. A lot of the lesser couples really struggling with the dance. Grytchukin and Platov making it look so easy.
Shailene Bourne, Viktor Katz.
So they led. And then we had Shailene Bourne and Viktor Katz for Canada. Bronze medalists in Edmonton in the Worlds last year. This was their Golden Waltz. A special mood. They went for elegance, one more impish performance from Grytchukin and Platov, but real serenity and elegance from Shailene Bourne and from Viktor Katz.
This is interesting, seeing the couples like this back to back. There's a completely different style. So such a contrast between the Canadian technique and the Americans as well, when you compare that with the Russian style. But nevertheless, very good. A natural flow, natural knee bend throughout the whole of the dance. These two really have created their own impression and own style to ice dance. And good to see quite a lot of the younger couples coming through, starting to copy some of their moves, in fact elaborate on them as well.
Tara Dubova with Marina Klimova and Sergey Ponomarenko put together this dance way back 10 years ago. And she seems pretty pleased with the way it's being transferred out there now.
That's got to be a help, hasn't it? Have be coached by the person that created the dance.
So that put Shailene and Viktor into second place. In fact, they were to end the first compulsory in joint second with Angelika Krylova and Oleg Obzianikov. And we're going to see the Russians rumba coming up in a moment or two. But now a chance to look at the French former silver and bronze medalists, Sophie Moniot and Pascal Lavanchy, a year out, a couple of years ago because of injury. But now Sophie back after her broken leg, and these two are in startling form here this afternoon. Pascal Lavanchy, gorgeous and beautifully skated.
Well, a tremendous battle in the French camp between these two and Marina Anasino and Gwendal Pizarro. Competition that went right down to the wire in the European Championships. These two eventually ending up on top, but there's no doubt about it that Moniot and Lavanchy are getting stronger and stronger after the return from that that awful injury. The confidence is there. And they're such genuine people that that really is portrayed throughout the skating.
Yes, very, very popular indeed. Not just the spectators, but amongst their fellow competitors, and a lot of them will be really supporting them. So that established them in fourth place, that particular dance, their golden wall. So after the first compulsory, it was Grzegorz Gompadov in the lead, then Born and Kratz, Angelika Krylova and Oleg Ovsyannikov,